Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we are going to discuss other partition values for frequency distributions. As we know that medians divide the given series or distribution into two equal parts, likewise quartile divides the data into four equal parts, quintile into five equal parts, sextile into 6 equal parts, decile into 10 equal parts, and percentile into 100 equal parts. All these mentioned above are the points of division. Now we shall discuss three useful measures which divide the series into 4, 10 or 100 equal parts, that is quartiles, deciles and percentiles. First we are going to discuss quartiles. As we have discussed, quartiles divides a series into 4 equal parts. And the number of points dividing a series is always 1 less than the number of subgroups. Therefore, for any series, there are 3 quartiles, that is Q1, Q2 and Q3. Q1 is known as first or lower quartile. Covering 25% items. The second quartile, Q2, is the same as the median of the series or fifth decile or the 50th percentile. Q3 is the third or upper quartile. Covering 75% items, and hence it is same as the 75th percentile. The difference between upper quartile and lower quartile is called interquartile range. Quartile deviation, which is also known as semi-interquartile range, is given by Q3 minus Q1 whole upon 2. Now we shall discuss formula for finding quartiles for individual and discrete series. Lower quartile Q1 is given by N plus 1 by 4th item, where n is equal to summation of f for discrete series and n is equal to number of observations for individual series. For continuous series, lower quartile Q1 is given by L plus I upon F into N by 4 minus C and size of N by 4th item is considered. Where L is the lower limit of the quartile class, I is the width of the class interval, F is the frequency of the quartile class, C is the cumulative frequency of the class just lower than the quartile class, and N is the sum of the frequencies given by summation of F. And similarly, upper quartile Q3 is given by 3 into n plus 1 by 4th item. Where n is equal to summation of f, that is the sum of the frequencies for discrete series, and n is equal to number of observations for individual series. And for continuous series, upper quartile Q3 is equal to L plus R upon S into 3 into N by 4 minus C and size of 3 into N by 4th item is considered. Where L is the lower limit of the quartile class, I is the width of the class interval, F is the frequency of the quartile class, C is the cumulative frequency of the class just lower than the quartile class, and N is equal to the sum of the frequencies given by summation of F. Now we are going to discuss decibels. It divides a series into 10 equal parts. There are 9 decibels for any series denoted by D1, D2, D3 up to Dn, known as 1st decibel, 2nd decibel and so on up to 9th decibel. The difference D9 minus D1, that is between the upper decibel and lower decibel, is called interdecibel range. Here, D1 is given by n plus 1 by 10th item. Similarly, D7 is given by 7 into n plus 1 by 10th item. And D9 is given by 9 into n plus 1 by 10th item. Where n is equal to summation of f for discrete series. And n is equal to number of observations for individual series. Continuous series D1, that is the first decibel, is given by L plus I upon F into N by 10 minus of C, where the size of N by 10th item is considered. Where L is equal to the lower limit of the decibel class, I is the width of the class interval, F is the frequency of the decibel class, C is the cumulative frequency of the class just lower than the decibel class, and N is the sum of the frequencies, which is given by summation of F. Now we are going to discuss percentiles. It divides a given series into 100 equal parts. There are 99 percentiles for a given series denoted by P1, P2, P3 up to P99. The difference, that is P90 minus P10, between the upper percentile and the lower percentile is called interpercentile range. and P1 is given by 10 plus 1 by 100th item, similarly P47 is given by 47 into N plus 1 by 100th item, where N is equal to the sum of the frequencies, that is summation of F for discrete series, and N is equal to number of observations for individual series. For continuous series, P1 is given by L plus I upon F into N by 100 minus C, where N by 100th item is considered. Similarly, P47 is given by L plus I upon F into 47 into N by 100 minus C, and 47 into N by 100th item is considered. Where L is equal to lower limit of the percentile class, I is the width of the class interval, F is the frequency of the percentile class, C is the cumulative frequency of the class just lower than the percentile class, and N is the sum of the frequencies given by summation of F. We should observe that for continuous series we use N by 10 for the first decil, 2 into N by 10 for the second decil, 3 into N by 10 for the third decil, and so on up to 9 into N by 10 for the 9th decil, and for percentile we use N by 100 for the first percentile, 2 into N by 100 for the second percentile, 3 into N by 100 for the third percentile. And in the case of individual and discrete series, N is replaced by N plus 1. Let us take an example. Calculate the quartiles, interquartile range, 8th decil and P47 for the following data, that is 4, 3, 1, 5, 7, 6, 2, 10, 8 and 9. We should first arrange the data in ascending order. Now we shall first find out lower quartile Q1, which is given by the size of N plus 1 by first item, here the value of N is equal to 10, so we have Q1 is equal to 10 plus 1, that is 11 by first item, therefore Q1 is given by the size of 2.75th item, which is equal to size of second item plus 0.75 into size of third item minus size of second item. Here the second item is given by 2 and the third item is given by 3. So we have the size of second item, that is 2, plus 0.75 into size of third item minus size of second item, that is 3 minus 2, which is equal to 1. Therefore we have 2 plus 0.75, which is equal to 2.75. Therefore lower quartile Q1 is equal to 2.75. Now we shall find out upper quartile Q3, which is given by the size of 3 into n plus 1 by first item. Which is equal to size of 3 into n plus 1 by 4th, and the value of n is equal to 10. So we have 3 into 11 by 4th item, which is equal to 3 into 2.75 item, as 11 by 4 is equal to 2.75, which is equal to size of 3 into 2.75, that is 8.25 item, which is equal to size of 8th item plus 0.25 into size of 9th item minus 8th item, here the size of 8th item is equal to 8 and the size of 9th item is given by 9. So we have size of 8th item, that is 8 plus 0.25 into size of 9th item, that is 9, minus size of 8th item, that is 8, which is equal to 9 minus 8, that is 1. So we have 8 plus 0.25, which is equal to 8.25. Therefore, upper quartile Q3 is equal to 8.25. Now we know that interquartile range is given by upper quartile minus lower quartile, that is Q3 minus Q1. And we know that Q3 is equal to 8.25 minus Q1, that is 2.75, is equal to 5.5. Therefore, interquartile range is equal to 5.5. Now we are going to find out 8th decil. 8th decil, that is denoted by D8, is given by the size of 8 into n plus 1 by 10th item, and n is equal to 10, so we have the size of 8 into 10 plus 1, that is 11, by 10th item, which is equal to size of 11 into 8, that is 88, by 10th item, which is equal to size of 8.8 item. That is, we have size of 8th item plus 0.8 into size of 9th item minus 8th item, so we have the size of 8th item, that is given by 8, plus 0.8 into size of 9th item minus size of 8th item, that is size of 9th item is given by 9 minus size of 8th item, which is given by 8. So we have 8 plus 0.8 into 9 minus 8, that is 1, which is equal to 0.8. 8 plus 0.8 is given by 8.8. Therefore, we get the value of 8th decil D8 as 8.8. Now we are going to find 47th percentile. 47th percentile, that is P47, is given by the size of 47 into n plus 1 by 100th item, where the value of n is 10, so we have the size of 47 into 11 by 100th item, which is equal to size of 517 by 100th item, that is equal to the size of 5.17th item, that is the size of 5th item, plus 0.17 into size of 6th item minus 5th item, now the size of 5th item is given by 5 and the size of 6th item is given by 6. So we have the size of 5th item, that is 5, plus 0.17 into size of 6th item, that is 6, minus size of 5th item, that is 5, which is equal to 5 plus 0.17 into 6 minus 5, that is 1, which is equal to 0.17 into 1, that is 0.17, and therefore we have 5 plus 0.17, which is equal to 5.17. Therefore P47, that is 47th percentile, is given by 5.17. thus we get the value of lower quartile Q1 as 2.75, the value of upper quartile Q3 as 8.25, the value of interquartile range is given by 5.5, 8 decil D8 is given by 8.8, and 47th percentile P47 is equal to 5.17. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.